Finally, at 5:30 tonight, they are indigenous. Who wrote that, I wonder? To Western New York, we're talking about char-broiled hot dogs and the people who just love to eat them. Our man Mike Randall stopped by one of the local haven for hot dogs today that's celebrating 70 years.
Who knows what makes a restaurant a success?
A huge failure rate in the restaurant business.
Maybe it's location, the food, or the friendly atmosphere that keeps customers coming back.
Oh, God, I've been coming here since about 1947.
Dennis McNaney and his wife Kay bought the Red Top hot dog stand in 1980.
Bingo, steamy. Take it easy, huh?
The McNaneys were the fourth owners here, and this year, the popular Southtown's business celebrates its 70th anniversary. The regulars look forward to the restaurant's annual March 1st opening.
It's a harbinger of spring, you know, so people think that when we open, the weather is going to be just fine from now on, and of course, we all know that that's not the case.
Nothing fancy here, unless you count those fancy fresh-cut fries made from locally grown potatoes. And hot dogs, char-broiled, of course, over real charcoal.
The secret to it is to have a good hot dog, and it's got to be cooked properly, and we try and cook it with a smile.
Not many changes here since they opened in 1946. Well, maybe a few.
And while the hot dog prices may have gone up a little bit over the years, the view is absolutely free and priceless.
Here at the Red Top, there is a prime view of the waterfront.
Everybody likes to see the water, and it is gorgeous. In the summertime, the sun sets, and some of the sights you see out here are beautiful.
Dennis will eventually pass his hot dog forks down to his daughter, Lisa. So the Red Top tradition will continue to welcome old friends.
We come here pretty often.
As well as the new. In Hamburg, Mike Randall, 7 Eyewitness News.